At one point, I think he got Nano Booster Dragon Blade in. He went up the top left side, threw onto the first point on attack, and the rest of his team were completely walled off and unable to follow up with him at all. They need just to gel a little bit more if they're going to get through.
Yeah, and I think for the Germans, it's a little bit of pride on the line here. We were mentioning yesterday, obviously, we saw Internet Hulk tweeting out in full German, something he doesn't often do, but obviously just speaking to his nation, his fans are back in Germany, and obviously just, you know, apologizing for the fact they didn't reach BlizzCon. It was a tough group. We knew it when we saw it get drawn out. We knew they were pretty much the underdogs, effectively, because Russia and USA were in that group. They were very strong teams. I think it's more just that they were disappointed with their performance. It's not so much that they lost the games, it's the performance in the games. So obviously we're going to be looking towards them here on the defensive side to see if they can bring something new, and they are. I'm seeing a Zenyatta from Kratos.
It's quite interesting here to see that one come out. It could be they've read into something Chile's bringing. I mean, you go with that Lucio here as well. You've got to be a little bit careful. You're going to have a little bit less mobility and a little bit less of an ability in general to react and to disengage or engage for that matter. But Kratos is hoping just to smash through people, use that Discord Orb to help burst down these tanks. It's a double tank setup for Chile, but it's more of a control map composition here, Lee. We've seen a Winston and a Zaya in the mix, no Reinhardt.
Yeah, this is going to be an interesting one. There's not really much of any hit scanner. RTI is in there, of course. That's what you like to see. A cheeky headshot on a Tracer as well from the orbs there, and it gets himself a second as well. So Kratos just showing, you know what, I can do quite a bit, not just sit here on an Ana or a Lucio. I can use the Zenyattas.
This is super risky as well from Kratos. So you play a Zenyatta into a Tracer and a Genji comp. You have a massive hitbox of Zenyatta, first of all, so you're very easy to hit and also quite immobile and vulnerable. So normally you don't want to play that against this combo from Chile, but Kratos is just, I guess, believing in himself to stay safe and sit back and have backup from his team. But this is what I'm talking about. Shell gets in behind. See, the wall goes up. The rest of his team might be split here, and Shell has to be very careful about how he engages.
They're trying to charge in this time. They've got a good chance, but Icefelt manages to pick himself up. A quick triple. RJ comes in, and the Chilean attack is stopped dead once again as RJ gets a second. And Germany hold strong. 2 minutes 40 on the clock, and Chile maybe need to be looking at switching something up here.
Well, I believe Icefelt means Icy Mountain, actually, in German. And yep, pretty much, I mean, he was living that life. Three kills for him. It's the Winter Wonderland, just the way he likes it. And good control as well. Made it very hard for Chile to move as a unit.
Yeah, well, here we go. Coming in once again. And Zaya, Incident Hulk, just catching them all out. Straight into a blizzard.
Again.
Not a great deal you can really do about that. Just getting caught up at the door, snarled up. This is something anyone that's played in solo queue will be all too familiar with.
Got some issues here, though, now. Germany's starting to get rolling with those ultimates. You saw Icefelt use the Blizzard there. There was also a Transcendence from Kratos, an ultimate that really shuts down Genji, but Gibran can still burst people down with the Pulse Bomb if it's in a Graviton Surge. There's no Sound Barrier available for Germany. They have to respect this, but Artia, he's in a good position to come from behind here. Sound Barrier was used for the side of Chile, and Petter now is going to open up against Kratos here. Things might backfire for Germany.
Yeah, that didn't work as planned, did it? And can see the Earth Shatter coming through as well. That was shielded off, so that didn't work out. Raw Scratch gets himself almost the full charge and just manages to knock them down. So Chile will cap out that first point. Germany, a little overconfident, I think it's safe to say. You could see the plan there. They were going to put the wall up, and RTA was going to catch out the squishy targets in the back. But it backfired. It didn't work.
This is one thing that I mean, the composition here for Germany was one thing I used to rip on Chinese teams about. Teams like NGA and Altstrike, sort of lower level, sort of tier two or close to the top Chinese teams, they always played the Ana without a Lucio. But on maps like this, right, it's not payload. Defending, you don't really have much room to sort of work anyway. You don't really need the speed boost, but the sound barrier is even more important than that. So we'll see if that's a problem that's going to be compounded. Now, Icefelt in a compromised position. He is forced into Icefelt very early. Now, pins it away as he just tries to get out of the action. That's thrown over towards the point. Now he's going to deal with Raw Scratch here in the corner. He's put up against the wall, and even if Chile wanted to move forward, they wouldn't be able to. It was getting very chilly inside.
Yeah, that was more of a panic move, I felt, from Icefelt there, as he got caught the wrong side of the wall, dropped down, and I don't think he was expecting to see Gibran sat there with the McCree. I think he was expecting to see maybe a flanking maneuver either way, but they used a lot of ultis there. They do just have Kratos' ulti, his Transcendence. So they should be fairly safe on the next push. Charles, of course, does have himself that Dragonblade ready and waiting to go. And they're trying to get a cheeky boost. Or was they, were they really trying to boost Ruster up? Or did they just boost him behind? Because he looked like he didn't move and just carried on shooting.
Marty going to drop down at the very least here as well. You're going to see that Skipjack is going to be left up top side there as well, just with the shield. Getting a lot of information, of course. He's up on that top right. Peeking that can be quite dangerous if the attacking team are ready to sort of pre-fire that. So you use a shield, but now Icefelt might be caught out again, straight towards the ice block here. Shell's got back up, and so does Germany. RT and Skipjack going to move forward. That's an Earth Shatter coming down. Icefelt and Internet Hulk again feature on the kill feed. And I have to say, this has been an excellent game so far from Internet Hulk. 4.2k damage right now, top on his team. And you can see he's giving the backline of Chile so many problems. Genji can't do much about Winston other than run away. And Anna is even more in trouble if she can't hit the sleep dart.
Yeah, Gibran going down to Ruster on the Anna there, right at the start of the fight. Popped in a headshot. You can see he's up on the ledge there. It's got almost the standard position these days for the Annas on the defensive side. And Germany, they're having a really good read on Chile here. Chile, you can see them setting up on the right-hand side again. Germany is sat ready for this one, so maybe Chile needs to switch things up. They have four ultis stacked up. They're going to have the Earth Shatter as well by Winston. Peter now comes through, so they have themselves a good ult build-up here. Icefelt doesn't have Blizzard yet, but he will have it during the fight.
Yeah, and that will be very important as well. Should be quite close now. See Kratos finds Raw Scratch early on. Rusty, see the grenade through. There was actually a Genji up towards his top left. Shao pressured him, so he drops down, gives himself a bit of extra healing, and now sets himself off towards the side. It's a transition. It's over to fight. Lots of healing for Germany here, and Chile can't break through it. They lack the burst. Deadeye is all they really have that can counter out Transcendence, and Kratos is using it very sparingly and very wisely.
Yeah, Icefelt now sitting on the big Blizzard. It is such a key ultimate level. It covers such a large area of this control point map. Assault map, I should say. The area they need to push on. If you go straight through the middle, which they're trying now, you can just slap it straight on top of them, slap it straight on the point, which is exactly what they're going to do, and it just slows everything down. It's actually frozen, I think, four people in there from the Chilean squad. There's nothing they could do about it. Earth Shatter follows it up, and you can see Internet Hulk just following through with that. Primal Rage at the end, maybe, okay. Not sure on that one. Maybe it was a little low on health.
I'm not sure if you wanted a quick jump reset, because what happens, right, if you get knocked down to the lower levels as Winston, and you don't have your jump pack on cooldown, that's bad if you're going to get pushed off the point. So if Internet Hulk maybe thought that there were still people from Chile on the point, then you use your ult, you get yourself another jump charge, and you can get back into the fight. Yeah, it was unnecessary. You're 100% correct there, because Chile were already taken down. But sometimes that's what you see. Miro likes to double jump as well. He jumps, then ults, then jumps again for extra height sometimes. Pretty sick to see.
Well, Ruster back in position. Scoping up. Oh, they've separated the tank out once again. Sepeta now going to get taken down. Skipjack gets himself the kill there. Transcendence used? Okay, they're going aggressive. They're going to push out. We're not really seeing it. Icefelt's getting himself around the side. He's just getting the free shots, but they are pushed out aggressive, and it's kind of backfired on them there. RJ actually gets taken down by Shal. Shal gets the heal off from Blanco, so now they're going to come back around the side. Shal's got his Dragon Blade up, so Germany got to be careful they don't go a little too aggressive here and get caught out, because they're all caught in the stairwell. Shal's going off with a blade. Is he going to be able to pick up any kills? No. The Biotic Grenade saves the day from Ruster.
Maybe a little bit aggressive from Shao there as well, but Germany thought after picking off Serpeta now they'd be able to wipe Chile out, get themselves some free ult percentage and have some time to chill, but it wasn't the case. Shao doing some serious work here. He finds Ruster. He's up on the top left off camera, but his Internet Hulk again finds Gibran. He is so good again in the back, but the damage is so real. It's electrifying, and Internet Hulk gets himself another kill on Blanco. My god, 6.7k damage, still top damage on this German team. And even Internet Hulk's having a bit of a celebration jumping across the point there. Love to see this Winston play, and it's working out well so far. 36. So,
yeah, 36 seconds. That's all that remains for Chile to try and push this point. It is probably one of the harder assault points. I don't know, maybe you could argue Volskaya maybe in there as well, but there's been a lot of arguments for everything, but Hanamura is definitely one of the tougher ones. There's going to be the copter going through. RTA doesn't really pick anything up. The Blizzard on top of it. It's just a multi-layered, faceted ulti strike, and you can see they're trying to push on the point. They've got themselves the second marker while it was all happening, so they're focused so much they didn't even notice that Serpeta now just went straight up the middle.
A good response from Kratos there as well. Transcendence, because they needed to answer the Earth Shatter. No time left for Chile. They are going to forced back off the point. Nicely done by Germany there as well. A little bit shaky on the first, but you can accept that most teams are going to struggle to defend that for an entire game. Shao was good on that Genji, then sort of switching to Reaper later on in the round, but RTM managed to wake up, really got things happening there. Saw him get charged by Petter now towards the end of the round, but that charge was cut short, and RTM was still able to make use of half of that nano boost. I believe it was because a Blizzard froze Petter now in midair, or something interrupted the charge. Either way, that was huge for RTA. And when you've got Internet Hulk creating so much threat on his own, RTA can just walk and kill as he likes.
So we're going to get to listen to exactly that winning moment from Germany.
how I became a team captain is a funny story. I was with another colleagues from YouTube. 2 days when we're supposed to be having the matches, they said, now you're team captain, here's the team, here are their contacts, good luck. And I was, okay, same day that we're having the match, it was really stressful, but we actually did really good. That was the first time that we played all together and say, okay, we think we got a team.
Well, Vardak, of course, was at Gamescom, but he's not a German. He is a Chilean.
Right.
A little word from Vardak, the captain of Chile.
If you want to hear winning moment from Germany, just imagine things like Krass, Jawohl, Sauber, Nice, just thrown in the mix there, and that's about right. That's pretty much what it would sound like. I mean, they've been quite quiet, though, the Germans, to be fair. When normally Internet Hulk wants to sort of create a bit of a louder atmosphere, they just don't seem to be, I guess, that pumped up. But that was a strong, clean showing from them. That's what Zalba means, by the way, in German. And I think it was nice from them. So we just need to see now if they're going to stay with Sindata on the attacking side. That'd be super interesting. I want to see if that actually happens, because there's vulnerabilities there, of course, in Zenyatta, like I said before, but there's no Genji for Chile on the defense here, so we'll see what he can do with that.
Well, we were talking about, obviously, God's putting himself on the market. RTA is out there as a free agent as well, so he's certainly the man that wants to try and make a bit of an impact here in this game. You can see him on Genji right now, getting that little flank around, trying to draw the attention of the Chilean players and maybe distract Charles so he doesn't land that wall. He does manage to get the ice wall down, but that's a quick answer to him. Gibran lands the flashbang and a bullet to the dome.
They timed that really well, just waited out the reflect there. Pretty standard stuff as a McCree player against a Genji, but Genji always stresses you out as McCree because you have one chance to kill him, and if you miss that flash, you are done like a dog's dinner. But Icefelt already managed to wrap his way around the back here, and Germany are playing with two flankers here, and you can see that, you know, with RTA working on one side, Icefelt to the other, this works best when both the flankers are alive and able to sort of generate threat. But look at that, it goes with a pulse bomb. Often you see that combined with another ultimate there, but Icefelt adds his damage to the heap, and that's what allows Internet Hulk to get Serpetta now, and then we're going to see Chile fall apart.
That's going to be a quick point cap as well, so that will cause some problems. I hope Chile don't try to defend this one. I assume they will not. We saw earlier on a team, I'm trying to think who it was, that actually tried to defend the point and then managed to end up just basically screwing themselves over, but it's not going to happen either way. I'll stop rambling and we'll see whether Germany can push back in.
Well, again, they've got like a decent time, of course, 6:35 on the clock here. Chile had a time to set up, though. You can see they're already up on the top left, which is generally the accepted best spot. But look at this, Gifted going to go in with a nano boost here. How interesting now. And the kills are coming in. Icefelt was there to combine with him. So the dive comp there for Germany actually working out. It's Gifted not taking any damage. He's demanding attention. He's taking threat away from his back line. And Germany just going to roll over the top here. Perfect execution.
I love the skillful aiming, I believe, of a Winston Skipjack just circling his mouse around the screen. He's like, I'm going to hit all of this area with my Tesla cannon. Easy stuff there from Germany. They flip it on its head and pick up that map very easily. Route 66 will be next for them. And Chile looking a little deflated after that one, I feel.
Yeah, look, that was just the perfect start to the fight there as well. And look, putting your team up on the top left side as Chile is generally quite common to see that. But if you can throw a Winston in, the jump pack knocks anyone off, that's great. Icefelt was already so deep in the back line there. And you can see that white gloves there for Kratos. He likes to wear gloves when he plays. It's not, I don't think it's a hygiene thing. I just think the tactility of it for him is what he's used to.
Well, of course, you can see the man on your screen there. Nearest to you is Internet Hulk. We managed to grab a few words with him before the tournament began.
I think the hero that represents my personality the best, actually the hero I play the most, would be Winston. He's smart, he can rage as well. I'm not really much of a rager, but if you poke me at the wrong time, I might go primal rage. Playing, doing well in a team, like having team play, organized strategies, I might be an MVP for my team in that regard. The new Overwatch become really big. I started doing weekly tournaments and now I live in America, traveling the world. I'm going from tournament to tournament. Now I'm playing on BlizzCon, which is like the dream itself. So I can definitely say hard work pays off in esports.
Solid stuff. Certainly a character, no doubt about it, Internet Hulk.
A story about him as well. Back when me and Jason first started casting Overwatch, way back in the beta, over a year, or almost a year ago now, this random guy called Internet Hulk sent us a message after a small ESL cut we did, and he said, guys, I think it was to Jason, he said, guys, look out for me. I'm going to be big in this game. I'm going to be a pro player. We're like, yeah, okay, buddy, no worries. You know, we'll see. And now, well, Dennis is pretty much at the top of the heap there as well. I mean, playing on the best team in the world, arguably at least in the moment, on Team Envious, and it all came true. It's just so impressive that he came into Overwatch, saying, I'm going to be the best, and he's worked his way up there as well. What a great performance from him in that last map. But let's have a look here. Second map coming in, Germany, ostensibly going to be defending here. I'm very curious to see what they go for. Yeah, no Torbjörn Varatia here, but the Reinhardt is interesting, though.
It was a map they struggled on against the USA yesterday. They managed to reach the second section, I believe. They didn't complete the map, if memory serves correct. However, Chile have yet to push out of this opening sector. Of course, big girls. Are we having some changes?
Yeah, everyone's playing a few different things, but I think they're discussing still at the moment. So Internet Hulk is a off Reaper player. He plays a reasonable amount of that. He sort of plays it for Envious if they need it, but not always the case. They're going to switch back. I don't know if they're trying to troll us. I wouldn't be surprised considering some of the guys on the Ruster, please. Not the Torbjörn. Anything but the Torbjörn. And Artia on the... Okay, Artia on the Reinhardt. Now, we saw a little bit more of this from Artia during the end of his tenure at Dignitas. He actually switched into more of that tank role as Bromas sort of picked up the DPS. We can see what Bromas does with McCree now as well. It kind of makes sense when you think about it.
So they've basically gone with a complete role switch, love.
Yeah, no, they're just doing... I honestly think they're just doing it for fun. Ruster plays a lot of Genji on ladder as well. I mean, he gets a lot of criticism for his Ana. I personally think he's quite good at it as well, but I mean, that's an opinion matter. And yeah, Hulk on Zarya plays a lot of it. Skipjack on Ana. A little bit interesting to me, but let's see how this works out. A bit of a mix-up for Germany, having a bit of fun with it.
Yeah, having fun with it. Well, Gibran's going to throw out the hook. Swing and a miss. Doesn't manage to land the first one, but it's something you got to keep your eye on. Of course, these players switching up their roles. They might not be used to quite their positioning. Of course, we're going to see the quick dive in there. Shard's going to try and upset things. RTA, though, swinging away, batting them off with the hammer. Internet Hulk managing to take himself his first kill of the game. Icefelt will chime in, and Chile are going to be forced back.
Yeah, important to note that Icefelt is the hitscan player for Luminosity, yeah. So this is very comfortable for him. He's a very good McCree. In fact, that's the kind of nice part about this team is that you've got multiple really strong McCrees here. Rusty Genji as well. Keep out for it. Coming to your screen soon. I'm looking forward to see what he can produce for us on this one. I don't know, everyone's, you know, this guy was a World of Tanks player, right? The last pro game he was in, though, that's going back a while. Didn't require a huge amount of mechanics, but more positioning. But since Ruster started playing Overwatch as well, he's really enjoyed the challenge of these mechanically intensive heroes. That's Ana to a degree, but also Genji. So we'll see now. Chile going to push back in here. Juban on that Roadhog, as you did already point out, but there's a Graviton Surge ready for Internet Hulk.
Yeah, but Sepeta now is kind of like on his own. He's just going up that side there, just chilling with the shield on his own. His team are not with him. He's just completely alone with his shield. Nobody else is with him, and I think they're not really picking him off either. They're just like, well, okay, you're not really going to go anywhere with that. He's going to get himself boosted up, though. It doesn't really matter, though, because as I say, there was no support there, and the rest of the team just getting picked off one by one as they flank around the map.
Yeah, Ross Grath was standing above him on the rocky outcrop, so there was some degree of support. Both teams nano boosted their Reinhardts there. The difference was that you're right, there wasn't as much follow-up behind Serpetta now, and Shao also got picked off at the start of the fight by Icefelt. That is his job. Deal with the Genji, don't allow Skipjack to get assassinated, especially don't allow Kratos to fall, and you'll be fine. This is a big, a large amount of ultimates coming up here for Germany, Lee. This could be very hard for Chile. They've allowed the German squad to get rolling, and they've got 5 ults to deal with.
Well, Internet Hulk's been sitting on that Graviton Surge for a long time. You're hearing the Dragonblade going off. That's going to be Shard diving in there. The Graviton Surge doesn't really pull too much in. Sepeda now finally gets himself a quick double there. Russo and Archie going down. So Rogue's reverse, but the Transcendence will hold strong, and Internet Hulk will just burst the rest of the team down, with Skipjack even chiming in with a kill of his own. Chile back to the drawing board. 1:30 to go.
So Shao now, this is a respect switch, by the way. It's like, I can't really get behind Icefelt. I can't deal with him that way. So Shao can now add, I guess, a little bit of that Reaper's damage to his backline if we're going to see Ruster go in. By the way, Ruster did go with the Dragonblade in that last fight, started off. Hey, Katie talks about this from Australia. He says he likes to play Reaper because you can be a bit more supportive in the backline in terms of your damage. Earthshatter came in there as well, but it didn't seem to have much effect. Maybe the shield was out there. Raw Scratch gets around the back of this fight. It was a sound barrier for Chile now, and a Graviton Surge comes in. This could be nasty for Germany. A lot of damage coming in. Biotic Grenade was used by Skipjack. It's helped a bit, but it may not be enough.
Ruster up the top there. He's not going to have a great deal of follow-up. You can see the rest of Chile forcing them back, and Germany maybe bitten off more than they can chew here, as Chile will move the payload and perhaps pick up their first marker here on Route 66. It's a big achievement for them. They've been struggling throughout this tournament. They're going to be very happy to reach these doors.
Okay, Germany don't want to drag this one out longer than it has to go, so a couple switches are being made here. Ruster's back to Anna, Artir's back to Reaper, Skipjack has picked up the Reinhardt yet again. So all battle stations as standard now for Germany here as we move into the second point. They had a chance to really hold Chile there, so if I'm honest, you're probably a little bit irate as Germany, as you had such a big ultimate bank and still got taken down. A lot of that ultimate bank was already used in the last fight. It's just going to be the Transcendence available for the Germans.
And if I'm not mistaken, it all began with RTA, who was on Reinhardt at the time, earth-shattering into the shields.
Yeah.
And that's just a classic case of not being used to Reinhardt.
It happens to everyone, though, as well. Yeah. Like, we've seen so many good Reinhardts miss earth shatters. It just happens. It's a very tricky game to play, but this fight's looking pretty good for Germany so far. RTA just dropping down to say hello. No need to use the Death Blossom. Too easy kills for him. With Shell managing to get with a bit of internet hulk, but he will be punished for that one. He tries to back away, he's caught by the flash, and Icefeld does the dirty work.
I think internet hulk's enjoying his freedom with the Zarya at the moment. Top of the damage table, currently for Germany and for the entire players, everyone playing actually,
yes,
so far.
Top
so
damage in this game, just behind Gibran, actually.
Yeah, just behind. So he's not doing a bad job, as it were. Maybe trying to, like, hey guys, I can use this other hero. I mean, please. But here we go. You can see Chile going to try and push up, but it's Germany that are all around the payload. They single out Sepetanao and Blanco. And the rest of the team, again, not with their tank. Without any damage dealers, he's got no one to shield. And he's also got no damage output, so he got simply singled out there. Skipjack picks himself up a quick double, and Germany reset themselves back on top.
And this is very dangerous for Chile now as well, because they have to filter through some very close quarters areas, and Germany can sort of spam that one down. They got Artie who can drop down as well now with the Death Blossom even available. Zarya can make it very costly in terms of help to move through. So Chile, yeah, this is, you don't want to be caught here. You want to be sort of out in the open. You want to have a bit of room to flex and breathe. And they've managed to push the payload forward, but you know Germany are about to pounce again. Ruster, it's going to be the Nanobu's time, and RTA's going in straight towards the back line. It's a one-way ticket, I guess, as well, if it ends up the wrong way. And it's going to be a flash in. RTA needs to do a little bit of damage here. Gibran actually had a Nanobu's himself, but he falls. RTA nailing shot after shot. Going to go within the melee attack, and this should be enough. Blanco will fall elsewhere. Internet Hulk and Icefeld doing work, getting rid of Chile, and it will be the wipe here. Germany will hold 34 meters after the first checkpoint. They're probably even annoyed to have actually lost that first checkpoint, but Chile are plucky. They managed to win out that team fight very strong. This was the Dragon Blade we talked about from Ruster that we didn't get to see. So, yeah, we talk about him being a Reinhardt player and a player. I like it to be on record that he can play heroes like this Genji fairly effectively.
It's now fucking up his stats as well there, but I think Gibran's going to be a little ruffled, I believe, after losing out in that quick duel with RTA towards the end there. Nano-boosted McCree losing out to a nano-boosted Reaper, and he managed to get the flashback in, so he interrupted the ulti, because he started his Death Blossom and he just got interrupted, but couldn't finish him off.
Frustrating, of course. I mean, I think a McCree nano-boosted, yeah. I mean, look, it's an interesting situation. Obviously, you get a few things. You get a damage increase, you get a speed increase, you get damage reduction when you're nano-boosted there.
And something we don't see is who's getting healed where.
The problem is, McCree beats Reaper by keeping him at sort of arm's length, mid to long range, and sort of picking him off like that. If you let a Reaper get in close, that's not good. If you let a Reaper get in close with a nano-boost, even if you have one, you're probably going to lose in the terms of the DPS battle, because obviously, you know, it's a shotgun. Hellfire shotguns, right? It's you do a lot more damage up close. It's pretty obvious, I think. And McCree doesn't really have the fire rate or the burst to deal with that in most cases, especially when the damage reduction is in effect.
So Germany making some changes. Looks like we've got a Mercy out there. There is no Pharah at the moment. We'll see where they stick with that, because they are on the attack, of course. They can make the changes as and when in these next 25 seconds. But Chile setting themselves up. Pretty standard stuff from them. They're going to go with the double support, and that is, of course, Blanco on Anna, Varduk on the Lucio. Cepeda now, as he's been playing all tournament, going to be on the Reinhardt. Raw Scratch will be on the Zarya. Of course, Gibran will be on McCree once again, and Charles this time on the Reaper.
Here we go. It might be the Bastion play for Germany. I have a feeling that might be the case. And they bring Artir along as well, just in case Chile start off with the Genji, who wants to try and dive to the back and deal with Icefield. Genji's kind of the biggest counter to Bastion.
So many shields. So many shields.
Yeah. So, this is going to be pretty scary. So Artir will just probably stick with the Bastion to a degree, try and offer some degree of protection, as Skipjack will be with the shield. But again, we saw South Korea pull this out. This is very scary. This is very hard to deal with, especially because Chile haven't started with the ideal comp to deal with this Bastion, and they won't have time to switch before this payload gets through if they get wiped here.
Yeah, Blanco nearly got triggered down there. They're going to try and push. They're going to try and back away, but you can see Icefell just backs away from there, can set himself back up. Everybody needs to get around that corner so they don't give the position away. That shield will get whittled down, but Gibran managed to get Skipjack down, so it does slow Germany down. The hook lands, does even get to net himself a kill though, don't know how. Somehow he gets away from it, and Icefelt is dealt with at last.
That was pretty nice there. You see how quickly Icefelt had to disengage when Chile went for the jump. If Germany had Lucio, that would be a little bit easier. Kratos obviously on the Zenyatta doesn't allow them to have that ability to back away easy, so maybe a consideration for later on, but you can see losing Icefelt hasn't really slowed Germany down too much. They've still got five players here. Then Nanoboost comes in, though. Look up towards the side, it's Shao. He actually gets hooked, knocked down. He's being CC'd to Oblivion right now, but he still gets a lot of damage done. It was Gibran, though, coming in from the back. A big three-man Deadeye. That deserves some recognition, and Chile are able to halt.
While that was all happening, you saw Skipjack actually got nano boosted, charged Cepeda now, did manage to take down Cepeda now, but obviously all the rest of his team completely exposed to a Charles who was nano boosted up and just managed to wreck through them. So Germany having themselves some problems here. 2 minutes 25, remember they're chasing a 34 meter lead. It is just through the doors, if you are unaware of that is, into the second section, so not too far. Raw Scratch, though, sitting on this Graviton Surge along with the Sound Barrier. Chile in a decent defensive position.
Yeah, we're gonna see them coming for the fight now. It's gonna be Germany pushing in now. Bear in mind, Zenyatta's Transcendence doesn't always protect you against a Nano Boosted Reaper. Every tick of Death Blossom can almost kill you in one hit. You have enough time to get the ticks from the healing to sort of go over the top of that. Chell's going to come in here as well. Transcendence was there. Notice the Bionic Grenade was over the top of the fight. So Chell got the ult off, but it wasn't really to any avail. He wasn't Nano Boosted. That makes a big difference against the Transcendence, because there's no way you can cut through the damage with that Reaper. And now Arctia, though, two quick kills. Graviton used into the hole. Perfect placement. It's going to pull the Chilean players off the top of the roof into clear sight.
Vardok's the only man that's just trying to tuck behind. There, he's actually stopping it, he's contesting it just up and around there. They realize where he is, he gets back
position.
Around it, just holds it for as long as he can. They knew exactly where he was. It's bought a little bit of time, so put it now back in position, but the rest of his team will not be back there before they reach the payload marker.
34 meters is now what Germany needs to achieve. They need to push forward a little bit more now. You can almost see the square just in front of Internet Hulk, and he's purposely just advancing a bit further than his team. He's trying to set the battle lines or the no man's land division a little bit further ahead of the gate so Germany can squeeze through without being contested. And, well, Chile are sort of acquiescing here. They're giving a lot of room. They're trying to get a bit of poke in with Gibran, but this is going to allow Germany to group up around that shield and keep that payload moving. Chile will have to engage in a moment. Deadeye coming up, but not the best vantage here from Gibran. His sight lines are a little bit sharp here. He might get the one, and yes, Arctia does fall, but it's a one-for-one trade so far.
Yeah, not completely convinced with that one. You saw him go for the flank. Skipjack, though, catches him out there. Doesn't actually get taken down, though. Manages to back away, but Icefelt's already picking himself up. Triple kill in the background. Raw Scratch comes in, but that is all she wrote. There's the golden marker. That's all they need to do. Just deal with one Lucio, and they will pick up the map and the game. Chile will fall to Germany 2-0. And it is all easy stuff for Germany in the end. They had a little bit of fun with it, a little bit of style in the end there, but they do pick up their one and only win in this Overwatch World Cup.
Yeah, I mean, we saw the roles get switched up on Germany at the start of that map in general, and it goes to show that you've got a lot of players that can play a lot of things, and the saddest part for me, or maybe not sad, but it's a shame we're not going to see them at BlizzCon, because they're a team who individually are so very good, they're quite talented, and they're diverse in their roles. Unfortunately, the way that they've come together and prepared sees a situation where this is a team that is less than the sum of their parts.